Hi, I'm Andrew Mazur from Mazur Wholesale, and I have another floor tile demonstration for you. Today, I'm going to be removing some tile. Now, if you've seen my video from over seven years ago, when I installed this black and white tile in my garage, well, first of all, you'll know that it's been here for quite some time. Now, here it's not looking so good anymore because, well, I don't really take care of it. I've never really cleaned the floor. This is for bicycles and trash cans and stuff like that. So the floor is a little bit beat up, but as you can see, it still looks pretty decent. And in the back of the garage, where we don't really have much traffic, the tile looks as good as new. But I get a lot of questions about how do I take the tile off if I want to? And this is how you do it. Now this tile, I've got a couple damaged tiles over the course of time from dragging heavy stuff across it. So I figure I'll demonstrate it right here with this damaged tile. This is a heat gun that you would use to strip paint. I picked this up at Lowe's or Home Depot or some hardware store. And it's a Wagner. There's expensive ones. This was cheap. It was only about 20 bucks. Just plug it in and turn it on, and it sounds like a low-powered hair dryer. But this thing gets hot pretty quickly. In fact, it's hot already, and I just turned it on. So I cannot get this stuff up with my fingers. Okay, It's the adhesive on this stuff, it is really good. And this is a cheap scraper. It's a little bit on the stiff side. You don't want to use like a dollar store scraper. You want to get something a little bit stronger. But watch what I do. I'm just going to heat this up now. Give it a little heat. I don't have to burn it off. I'm just going to warm it up. And already, the glue is beginning to reactivate. After 7.5 years being down here, I'm getting this putty knife under the tile, and it's sliding through pretty easily. And I've never done this before. This is my first time ever doing this, but I thought, the information my people want to see. I have quite a few videos talking about tile installation. I don't pretend to be an expert. I do sell this stuff. I've been selling it for almost 20 years now on a website. And the reason I do these videos is mainly so I can answer my customers' questions. Now, it's a heck of a lot faster to install this tile than it is to take it off. Now, I'm just going to peel it back, see what happens. Oh, good. It's coming off all in one sheet. Oh, wow. That's great. That's great. So, that was easy. Now, there's still some tackiness down here, but it's not real, real sticky. It's just tacky. And now, if I wanted to, I could just drop another tile right into place right here. And that's what I recommend for all my customers when they buy this tile. I always say buy enough so that you have some leftovers. Because if you have leftover, then you can always replace tiles over the course of time. It's inevitable that some tiles will eventually get damaged from sliding a piece of furniture. In this case, I slid an old refrigerator across this floor, and I did some damage to a couple of tiles. I didn't care to fix it. It's just my garage, and I didn't really care. But so many customers ask me, how do you get the tile off the floor if you need to? Well, we just did it. This is the first tile I ever removed, and as you can see, it was a cinch. If you have any more questions, you can just leave a a note down below this video right here on YouTube, and I have lots of we have lots of other videos talking about our floor tile and preparation advice and things like that. So I hope this helps you. Thanks a lot for watching. I'm Andrew Mazur from Mazur Wholesale.